There is still no official cause for Sunday's deadly commuter rail accident in New York City, but the investigation this morning is fully focused on the train's engineer, William Rockefeller. His lawyer confirms that the driver's attention wandered before the crash. Jeff Pugues is at the scene in the Bronx. Jeff, good morning.
Good morning, Charlie and Nora. Rockefeller met with NTSB investigators last night, and his attorney says he told them that he experienced a, quote, hypnotic-like daze just before the train veered off the tracks. Increasingly, the attention is focused on the engineer, especially since officials discovered that the train had been traveling nearly triple the speed limit. In the critical moments before Sunday's deadly derailment, William Rockefeller Jr. wasn't completely focused. According to law enforcement officials and rail union chief Tony Batalico, the engineer said he slipped into a daze just before the crash.
He zoned out. He had one of those where, whoa, you know, like, you know, you drive your car and, you know, you stare at the same thing for so long and, you know, he zoned and he caught himself, but he caught himself too late.
Tuesday, the NTSB said that alcohol tests for Rockefeller and the crew came back negative. Officials wouldn't comment on the engineer's state of mind, but did say so far they've found no sign of mechanical trouble.
Simply put, based on these data, there's no indication that the brake systems were not functioning properly.
Just 2 weeks before the crash, the NTSB says Rockefeller switched from a night shift to a day shift. He clocked in for work Sunday at 5:04 a.m., the second day of a five-day work week. He typically worked nine-hour shifts and was supposed to make two round trips that day.
There's every indication that he would have had time to get full restorative sleep.
Rockefeller hasn't been seen publicly since the crash, but former MTA supervisor and friend Michael McClendon came to the engineer's defense.
To say safety was, you know, something uncommon to him, it was everyday practices for him.
There has been a tremendous amount of progress clearing the tracks here over the last couple of days, and this morning some commuter service through this area resumed. Charlie, Nora.
All right, Jeff, thank you.